Hello, hello! Welcome back to my channel. I'm so glad you're back today because I'm starting a new series. This is my adding to the wish list or not so much. And I'm going to go through all the new makeup releases of this last week or the releases that are announced this last week. And I'm going to see if I want to put them on my wish list or not. And if you want to see my wish list video, I linked it up here. I'm also going to put on a new low buy update kind of a video on Thursday where I am explaining why I use my wish list as a guidance for my shopping. So if you're interested to see what the new releases are and if you want to know if I'm going to put them on the wish list or not, then please keep on watching. Okay, I scooched over a little bit because I can put a picture of the products up here beside my head so you can see what I'm talking about. I'm going to talk off my phone today because I use Instagram for my inspiration, really. I always watch beauty news. I watch the Will I Buy It by Samantha March. Mel Thompson has something like this in a video, so yeah, I really enjoy watching them, and I thought maybe I could make my own series about what type of releases I am interested in or not, and why. And for this video, I'm going to be on my phone a lot. I'm going to watch my phone a lot because I use Instagram for this. And I'm going to use the Trendmood page. I'm going to link her down below. And I'm going to use the page by Beauty News. And I also follow a few indie brands. So if I see something, I'm like, oh, that's interesting. Then I'm going to talk about them as well. I'm going to start off with the new Urban Decay foundation. It's the Stay Naked foundation. It's a liquid foundation and it comes in 50 shades and they're going to be $39 each. I am trying to see if I can see when it is going to be released. No, it just says coming soon. I have never tried a Urban Decay foundation, so I'm quite interested to see if this is something I will like. I don't think I'm going to put it on my wish list just yet. I'm just going to see the reviews and see if this is something that is going to be for me, and then maybe I'm going to add it and I'll let you know if I did. Then the next thing by The Balm. The Balm are releasing. I can't really see if it's already... Oh, available now. No, it's available. Okay, they have released like a... It's an highlight shadow blush duo. And I think you can just use it on your eyes and you can use it on your face. The photo seems really glittery. So I don't know if I would really use this as a blush. Maybe a little blush topper. I don't mind a little shiny or glowy blush in summer, but I'm not really into very shiny shiny blushes, and if I use a highlight, I'm not going to use a pink one. And I think I am most intrigued by the Dusk and Dawn palette, so, but am I intrigued enough to put them on the wish list? They're $26 each, and I don't know if I can get them in Holland easily. I think I can get it on Beauty Bay or something. I do have a lot of blushes, so I think I'm going to skip this. I think I'm going to skip it. The next one is definitely going on my wish list. Pat McGrath is coming out with new nine shades. Of the sparkly bullet, and the regular sparkly bullet is very, very sparkly. It's very metallic-y, and I have to say, I'm not really about that sparkly life on my lips, but I have to admit that I really love the Ciate, the red lipstick by Ciate in the Jessica Rabbit collection. So maybe I'm judging too hard, but these look so pretty. These are such beautiful shades, as you can see. And they have a swatch, especially the swatches on the lips of the girls. They look so pretty. They look so pretty. I have to say, I can't even decide which shade I want to try because I really love them all. especially those reds are so beautiful. But also the pinks and that like corally one. It is so pretty. It is so pretty. So this is definitely going on my wish list. They are going to be $38. It's 9 shades. And they are available now. So I think I'm going to see if I can pick them up in London. I think I can get Pat McGrath in store so I can swatch them there. I don't think the limited edition doesn't say will be available June 14th on Sephora, online and in stores. No, it's not. It doesn't say it's a limited edition. So I'm going to wait until I'm going to London. I'm going to London with friends in, I think, September. So yeah, I'm going to put these on my wish list and swatch them in store and see if I'm going to get it. And I'm going to let you know if I did. Okay, next one is the summer edition of the MAC Fix Plus, and they're having some travel size ones in very lovely scents, and I'm definitely going to get some of these. I'm hoping they're going to put them in a pack because it's easier that way to pick them up, but I really want to try the pineapple one, I really want to try the watermelon, and I really want to try the white tea and the peony. The only thing I'm not that interested in is the cucumber because, you know, cucumber is cucumber. It's a fresh scent, but I don't necessarily need it on my face. So, yeah. I hope they have it in a pack. I'm going to check if I can find some background because they are available now online at Sephora Canada. And they're coming soon online and in stores. So, I'm going to see if I can enter the site of the Sephora Canada. I don't think so because I get kicked off the American one and be redirected to the French one. Don't ask me why, because it's annoying. I don't speak French or read French, so why I can't just get on the Sephora USA, I don't know. Sephora, please fix that, okay? Thank you. So, but definitely going on the wish list. This is definitely going on the wish list. I'm going to mark them. Okay, then I'm going to a new Suiva release. They are sneak peeking a summer collection, and it's mostly face stuff. I see some blushes. I think a shimmery bronzer. I think it's an eye palette. And some drops. If I have more information, I'm going to put them on the screen or down in the description box. But I can get Suiva in stores in Holland, so I hope this is coming to Holland as soon as it will release in France or America or wherever. I want to swatch them first because I am intrigued because I look a lot like Hourglass. I got some Hourglass vibes from this. So I really want to swatch them before I buy because maybe they are going to be very shimmery. And now I don't really mind shimmer, but I don't like a shimmery bronzer or a shimmery blush. So I'm going to see if this is something I want, but I'm not going to put it on my wish list. Then going to BH Cosmetics, they have done a collaboration. I think this is one of two things that are coming by BH Cosmetics that I have seen. I must say, to be honest, I'm kind of intrigued by this because it's very colorful and it's done with Tina Young. Young? I'm sorry if I'm butchering this. But I think it's Tina Young. And they have a gorgeous palette. It's one palette and it's a face and eye palette. It's going to be $24 and it includes 12 eyeshadows, 2 highlighters and 4 blushes, and one of them can also be a bronzer. The colors are quite interesting, but it's a little jumbled also. It's not like I'm looking at this palette and I'm like, okay, yes, I'm going to create this and this and this, only a sunset or a sunrise color on my eyes and the rest are just some pops of color. So it's fun. Yes, indeed, it's fun, but I wouldn't say it's versatile. The only thing that is handy, maybe, if you're going on a holiday, is that you also get your face products in one fell swoop. So, yeah. It's funny, though, because it's like, I like colorful and playful, but then you see the picture for the marketing picture from her, and it's really gold and neutral. Okay, this is not going on the wish list. I'm going on. Next up is from L'Oreal. They are releasing some new liquid lips in the Infallible collection. And they are going to be macaron scented. So it's like the chocolate ones, but now they're not smelling of chocolate, but of macaroons. Not a bad thing, necessarily. They're going to be $9.99 in 7 shades. They're going to be smudge proof, long wear, full coverage matte lipstick. And they are infused with notes of almond, vanilla and cream. And the colors look really pretty, but I don't like liquid lipsticks. I never wear liquid lipsticks. And if I do, I always regret it because I have to babysit them a lot. And I don't really like that. So this is going to be a pass for me. But the colors look really nice. So if you're into liquid lipsticks, I think it could be a good one. Then something different from Halo, from Tati Westbrook. I saw the video where she is announcing her new product for her Halo line. And she has made a full, like a multivitamin. And they made a multivitamin for guys and for girls. And yeah, I think, a logical step for her. I hope she's coming out with some maybe skincare or makeup in her next release. But I think she likes being on this supplement train. So yeah, maybe she wants to keep going at that. But I think, yeah, now it's, if you have a multivitamin, I get it. But it's like a body and brain booster. So I'm like, this is not, to me, it's not really beauty. It's really supplement. It's really more of a drugstore thing or a pharmacy thing. I am on Kiwi at the moment. I keep forgetting to take them every day, so I try to be good. I haven't taken them today. I have to get them today. I have to take them today. But I don't think I'm going to go in with a multivitamin. I am not someone who is very diligent in taking my vitamins. I've tried. We have like a whole collection of them in our kitchen, but I'm not that good in taking them. And I'm not quite sure yet how these supplements really are adding to my health. I read all types of articles about them, and I see all sorts of documentaries, and one is saying it's great, the other says it's not a necessity if you eat very balanced. Now, I don't really eat that balanced, so I should maybe be taking them, but I think I'm going to skip this. I'm going to try to see if Kiwi is something I want to keep taking and be on. But having to get them from America is quite expensive already, and if I have to get these as well, then it's going to be a very it's going to be a very big expense, so I don't think I'm going to do that. The next thing is Maybelline. They have a Super Stay Ink crayon, and they say get up to 8-hour matte lip color that glides on crayon easy. Draw it in and bring it on all day. Okay. This looks intriguing because it has its own sharpener. I think that's good. And the colors are pretty. And it says Super Stay Ink crayon. So I think if it is going to be long lasting, but it's going to be creamy because it's a crayon, then I think it's going to be the perfect combination. So I think I'm going to put this on my wish list because I'm curious to see how they are going to hold up. Because they say that you have effortless control and that it's going to last up to 8 hours of wear. I'll be the judge of that. I'll be the judge of that. But I'm going to put them on the wish list because I think they are intriguing. And they are $9.49 or £9.99. Why is that more expensive? That's weird. They are available now at Ulta Beauty, Superdrug and other Maybelline stockists. I have no clue if that means they are going to be in Holland. I'm going to check my local pharmacy if I can find them. Or pharmacy, not pharmacy, drugstore if I can find them. And if I do, I'm going to let you know what I think of them. Then the next thing I'm definitely going to get this. Charlotte Tilbury is releasing some new lipsticks, but what she does, the case is going to be refillable. So you can have your own beautiful package and just refill the package. And it looks so stunning. I can't even decide what my favorite one is, because I really like that panther print one, the golden one. But I also like the one with the panther on it, because it's so like panthery and vixen like. So this is going on the wish list as well. They say coming soon. Charlotte will keep you updated. I hope Trend Mood will as well. I'm going to let you know when they are here. I can't really see a price indication for them. They're not going to be cheap, I can tell you that, because Charlotte Tilbury is not cheap. But I really like her lip formula. So yeah, I'm going to mark this down as being on the wish list. Then the new release by Tarte. Tarte has released a new eyeshadow palette. And I must say, I know I'm not going to put it on the wish list. No, it's not interesting enough to put it on the wish list. But for Tarte, it's very different. And I know, well, not that different really. Because if you look at the pineapple one, the Christmas one, or the holiday one, they also have these sorts of colors. But I'm really drawn into the colors, I have to admit. Because I like the warm shades, I like the pop of teal, I like, it's quite versatile, this palette. And when I see it, I look at it and I can immediately think, oh, I want to create this look, or I want to create that look. Then for me, it's okay, because then I'm drawn in. And I think they are releasing some highlight as well. They look like pretty highlights. I think with highlights, to be honest, people are like, oh yeah, they're gold, yeah, they're champagne-y, we've seen it. And then I'm like, yeah, I know, but you're not going to put like green highlight on your face, at least I am not. So I'm not too mad about the colors. I think the colors will be really flattering. It's just that I would like to know what the formula is, because if it's really chunky and it's going to really enhance some texture on my skin, I don't enjoy it. So if it's a nice formula, then maybe it can be a very pretty highlight. And then they're releasing some eyelashes. I'm not one that wears a lot of false eyelashes, so I'm not really that interested. And they are releasing a travel size Big Ego mascara. Next thing is the Pixie Pretties. They release a eyeshadow palette, looks like a highlighter palette, some lip products, some eyeshadow products, I think, like shimmery eyeshadow products. Yes, they have collabed with Mariam NYC, I think. These are two sets of liquid fairy lights. They're matte lost liquid lip. They're two sets, they're $18. Then the lip icing with Chloe Morello. Three new shades, $14. Bonbon Parfait and Sorbet. Then they have collabed with FRM Head to Toe. Glow powders Yvette and Wednesday. And the shade stick in One and Done. What's a shade stick? Is a shade stick something you can use to contour or something? I think so. I don't know. It's shiny. I don't know. And with Rage Loves, they have released a highlighter palette. It's $24 and 5 shades. I usually watch Rage Loves. I really like her. I am in the Facebook group from Beauty News, and there was some discussion about her being pro-life. That doesn't really stop me from buying a product if I like her or if I like the product. I think she's a nice girl, and everybody's entitled to their own opinion, so I'm not going to be all, you know, against this release with her. I have my own opinion about this whole pro-life thing, and it's not the same as hers, but that's okay. Everybody's entitled to their own opinion, as long as you're not forcing it on other people. So I think it looks interesting. I think the eyeshadow palette looks interesting. I know it's not very revolutionary in colors, but it's very wearable. And I would love to wear it. And also the highlighter palette by Rachel Loves. It looks fun. It looks like fun. And I know that the Pixi highlighters can have a very, very nice formula. So if it's good, then maybe I will get it. But the thing is, it's not very easy for me to get it in Holland, so I'm not going to put it on the wish list, especially because I think I've already put 4 things up. And if I put them against this release, then I'm like, yeah, but I love the Charlotte Tilbury things and stuff more than this. So I'm going to skip this one, but I like the release. I like it. Then, Pat McGrath is coming out with complexion products and people are raving. They are so excited about this and I get why, because it's Pat McGrath. She's releasing 4 products. She's going to release a Skin Fetish foundation. It's going to be in 36 shades and it's going to be $68. Okay, for 35 mils. That's okay, but it's, I think $68 is really expensive. So it better, you know, wash my car as well. Cover all my sins. I don't think it will, but you know. Will have a satin finish, sheer to medium buildable coverage. Sheer to medium buildable coverage for $68. Girl. It's self-setting. So it is self-setting, but it's also going to be a setting powder in this collection. So, okay, that's weird. The setting powder is going to be $55. The primer is going to be $60. And the face brushes are going to be $60. Oh no, there's no price here. And it will be available on July 26th at Pat McGrath and Sephora, I think. I think it will be coming all over the world eventually. This is not going on the wish list right now. If I'm going to see very good results or very good reviews from other people, then maybe I will consider it. But I think $68, like I'm saying, it better cover all my sins. And I don't think it will. I don't think it will. Then the next thing is by Milani. Milani is going to release or have released. It's available now. They have released 2 eyeshadow palettes. They look very shimmery. Looks like both of them have like one. No, they're all shimmers. They're all shimmers. And it's okay. They have 16 shades. They're going to be $19.99. One is Gilded Noir. That's the black cover, and the other one is Gilded Rouge. It's the red cover. No. No, I'm sorry. This is not going on my wish list. I'm not really drawn in. I think the rouge one is okay with the purples and the warm tones. It looks like fun, but all shimmers. Then I always have to use another palette with it. I don't mind doing that, but it's not like, you know, you're going to have 16 shades and it's all going to be shimmer. All of them are going to be shimmer. Even the darker ones are shimmers. And the noir one, it's just too dark. Then I have a new palette by Violet Voss. It's already available and it's called I Do Not Care, but it's I Do Not Care. That's fun. I think that's fun. I like the colors. It's like it's a fun, colorful palette. It's just not a very complete palette. And it's not really... The only thing that is getting me is the donuts on the cover. I like to have a donut now. That's the only thing that is really taking me in. The rest is like, yeah, it's fun colors, but we've seen them. You've probably already have them in your collection already, especially if you have bought, you know, the Alyssa Edwards or the Riviera palette, or if you have some rainbow palette, any rainbow palette, then you probably already have these colors. So yeah, it looks fun, but it's not going on my wish list. Then ColourPop, of course, ColourPop has released some stuff. They have released 7 shades of glitter, and they're in these little pots. They're going to be $7 each, or $40 for the bundle. I have made a ColourPop order. It's coming to me, I think, in like 2 weeks because it takes a while to get to the Netherlands. And I think I have a picture of them coming. I got the blush sticks and the highlighter stick in the Magnolia pack. And I got eyeshadow palette Here Comes the Sun. And Here Comes the Sun is special to me because it's a special song for me. We played it at my wedding and it's the first song I heard when I was a baby, because the obstetrician, I think it's called, when I was born, he asked my dad if he could play the guitar. My dad plays guitar and he always has a guitar in the living room, so he said yes, you can please do, and he started playing Here Comes the Sun. So Here Comes the Sun is a special song for me and my dad, and if you're going to name an eyeshadow palette Here Comes the Sun, I have to have it, if you know what I mean. I'm going to put them up. So these are on my wish list, and they're already off my wish list again because I already picked them up. I've got another thing I want to talk about. The concealer from Maybelline. They have made a Super Stay Full Coverage Long Lasting Under Eye Concealer. And it's in their Super Stay range, so it's in the Super Stay foundation. You already have a liquid one. I think there's a stick one. They got the lip crayons coming, and now they have these, the concealer. It's coming soon online at Maybelline and in stores. So I think you can just get it in store at some point. And I'm intrigued by it because I haven't found my Holy Grail concealer yet. Not my Holy Grail foundation either, but I haven't found a Holy Grail concealer yet, so I really want to try this out because it's full coverage. And yeah, I'm really intrigued to see if it's going to be any good. I think they're going to be in 12 shades. They've curated it okay, but I think the 12 shades is just a teensy bit too little. I think it's going to be a little, I think 12 shades, it's okay if you're going to make sure that you are catering through a very big line. But if you say it's going to be full coverage, then a lot of people won't be able to find their shade. So 12 shades, it's not a lot, I think. I think they should do better, but I want to try it out. So I'm going to pick one up. So it's going on the wish list. This one is somewhere. I want to just show you this one. I'm not going to get it. I'm not going to put it on the wish list because I don't think the colors are that interesting. But I want to show you because maybe you love SpongeBob. And SpongeBob is just, it's so cute. SpongeBob's so cute. And what I really love about this palette is they stayed quite true to the theme, because they have like three yellows in a 15 pan palette. They have three yellow shades, so they've got the greens for Octo, I think he's called, and they've got like 3, 4, 5-ish pinky colors for Patrick. So I think this is so much fun and it's so cute. It's by Hip Dot. And it's going to launch at the 17th of July on their own website. It's going to be limited edition. So if you are interested, then check Hip Dot out because it's so much fun. It looks so much fun, but I'm not going to get it. Then something I think looks really cute. I'm not going to get anything from this either, but I think it's a very fun little collection. It's by Wet n Wild, and they teamed up with Pac-Man, and what they are coming out with is a powder brush, an eyeshadow brush, a nail polish set, a blush palette, eyeshadow palette, powder bronzers, lip balm, glosses, and lipsticks. And I think it's just cute. I have a few, I think, complexion products and some eyeshadows, and from Wet n Wild, I like them. They perform quite nicely, but I don't need anything. I don't need another brush. I don't need nail polish. I rarely wear nail polish. I don't need any blushes. Oh my god, I seriously don't need any blush. Eyeshadow palette, I can't really see it, so I can't really say if I'm going to be intrigued. The only thing that is really screaming, get me, are the lip balms. Because the lip balms are in these little round containers, and I hope it's going to be like a mini Pac-Man And yeah, that's the only thing I'm like, okay, if I can get it easily, then I would get it. Then another thing from BH Cosmetics, which I have to say intrigued me a little. It's the Stellar Collision Palette and it's a full shimmer. It's only shimmers. And I like, because it's I like the palette. It looks really jumbled, but it's like the galaxy. So yeah, I'm really intrigued by this. The only thing I am not that intrigued by is that it's only shimmers. And it's the colors are not that different from each other. So that's the only thing that is keeping me from putting it on the wishlist. But otherwise, it looks really pretty. It looks really fun. So yeah, I think I think this is a very fun little palette. Then the last few things I want to mention are some releases by indie brands. I saw that Luxie Beauty is coming out with 4 new shades. They're going to be $4 each and you can use code JOY10 for 10% off. And yeah, it looks really nice. I think they are very pretty shades that you see them, but because of the duochromes and they're a little bit darker, I think it's nice to make, you know, more of a smoky eye, shimmery smoky eye, and I love that in summer. So I think I'm going to check them out because $4 is not a lot. So for $16, you've got all 4. That's nice. They are available now on their website. So then I saw a green palette. I love green. I think it's a bit too frocky green, so I don't know. The Luxie ones I'm going to put on the wish list, definitely, definitely. This one I'm not too sure about, but it really looks cool. It's by Blushtribe and it's their Layla 2 palette. And yeah, I think it's kind of like you got all your sort of greens, because it's like murky greens, and you've got the deeper greens, but you also have the true grass greens, and you've got like a minty. That Maria color is really cool. Yeah, so it looks really pretty. I'm not going to get it because I already have some of these colors by Davina Cosmetics, so I'm not going to get this one. But I wanted to show you because I think it's very on trend, very on the green trend, and yeah, very pretty, pretty, pretty palette. So that concludes this week's wishlist adding, and I'm going to count how many things I've added. I'm going to put the wishlist on the site so you can see what I've added, and the new things are from Luxie Beauty. So that's one. Urban Decay, I'm not going to do yet. Then the Pat McGrath lipsticks, that's two. The Fix Pluses in the Nice Little Scents, the travel sites, that's three. Then the Charlotte Tilbury is 4. Where are you, my darling? Yes, number 4 is 1 or 2 of the new lipsticks by Charlotte Tilbury. And I thought I had a 5th edition. Oh, right, yeah, the Here Comes the Sun Colorful, the Here Comes the Sun Colourpop palette, but I'm going to put it up. It's the 5th one, but it's already on its way to me, so. Okay, guys, that's it from me today. It's a very long video. I think I'm already rambling for almost 50 minutes. It's going to be a very long one. Let me know if you like a longer video in the series, or if you want me to crop it down a little, maybe just discuss like a max of 10 products. Please let me know, because yeah, it's a new series for me and I really want to know your feedback. I also would love to know what you thought of the products I showed you today. If you are the same as me, if you want to pick up the same stuff, or if you saw something I'm going to skip but you would love to get, please let me know. I'm so curious. I love to just chat makeup with you. So please let me know down in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. Please, if you like this video, then give it a thumbs up. That really helps me along to see what type of videos you prefer to see. If you haven't subbed, then please subscribe. And otherwise, I will see you in my next video. Bye.